Hey guys, welcome back to another Wild Darkness video. Today I'm going to show you guys 5 tips and tricks in the Wild Darkness. Before we continue, 0% of you who watch my videos have subscribed. So if you enjoy these videos, consider subscribing. You can always change your mind later. Number 1. Always keep moving. Never stand still. This is one of the most common mistakes I have seen so far. This happens when you're new to the game and you're trying to figure out how to survive the first 2 nights. Luckily, I just made a new video about how to survive the first 2 nights. You can go to the video by clicking up here. If you're not moving or doing something, you're wasting precious time that could mean life and death. In this game, survival factors like food and monsters are very harsh on you. Some monsters and animals do tons of damage. Food barely heals you and is extremely scarce. If you don't move, you will face the consequences. Number 2. Torch weakens enemies. Having a torch by your side when fighting an abyssal shadow will weaken it during combat. If you don't know what the abyssal shadow is, it's a monster that comes at night or in caves that attacks you. The torch makes shadow monsters smaller, symbolizing weakness or making them weaker. The abyssal shadow looks exactly like the ominous shadow, which you might get confused with. You can tell the difference between them by their names, shape, and the damage they deal. The abyssal shadow does more damage than the ominous shadow. The abyssal shadow is like the Chad version of the ominous shadow. Also, I think the campfires work the same way torches do to monsters. Number 3. Always cook your food. I actually don't know if eating cooked food over raw food has any benefits like healing your health in this game, but in real life it makes sense, so I'm just gonna say that you should always cook your food. Most foods you pick up from the ground or killing animals can be cooked like meats and fruits. Plus, you don't lose anything in return from using your campfire to cook. Number 4. Sneak attacking. This is the sneak button. It allows you to, of course, sneak. There is one main usage of this mechanic. It allows you to sneak up on an enemy or an animal and do a sneak attack. Sneak attacks give you the upper advantage before starting a fight. You will lower the enemy's health, and when you start fighting, you will lose less health and have a higher chance to not die because your opponent will have fewer attacks due to their health. This mechanic is really useful since in this game, it's very difficult to regain your health back. Basically, less health equals fewer attacks from opponents. Fewer attacks equals you lose less health. Number 5, you can zoom in and out. This will be very useful for scouting out your surroundings and decide where to go. Scouting will allow you to suspect any monsters nearby that may harm you. You also don't want to wander around aimlessly like a headless chicken, so scout your surroundings and see what's the fastest and most efficient way to move from point A to point B. This wraps today's 5 tips and tricks. I hope you enjoyed it.